Welcome to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting underway shortly. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Lots of low-speed exits means the rears are in for a lot of punishment. It's all too easy to spin them up coming out of a corner too aggressively. It might look great for us as spectators, as we love to see a car driven beyond its limits, but it's not going to result in a great long-run pace.
Should be able to get into the next qualifying session easily, so try to get a hot lap in early so we can save the tyres.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. A Williams, Raikkonen, and Lewis Hamilton. Goodbye for now then, but...
Hello. I just wanted to pass on the team's expectations for this race. Good luck.
They say that even a second is an eternity in Formula One, so going four winter months with no racing at all has seemed a very long time indeed. We're back though in Melbourne, home of the Australian Grand Prix since 1996. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 16 corners and 3.3 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles an hour. The close proximity of the barriers makes accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. I'm joined today in the commentary box, as I will be throughout this season, by a great racing driver, a former F1 competitor, a man who was world champion once upon a time as well, and an all-round top chap. It's the one and only Anthony Davidson. And tell me, here we are, first Grand Prix of the season, the first time racing these cars. So what are the big questions that need to be answered here, in your view?
First of all, Crofty, and thanks for the glowing introduction. I just want to say it's a real privilege to be here, and I can't wait to see what this competitive field has in store for us this season. Now, to answer your question, obviously there's the question of performance in race trim, but really this is going to be all about reliability. It's the first Grand Prix of the season, don't forget. You're pushing all your new components to their limits. Formula One cars are full of very sophisticated but also very sensitive technology. So the most important thing today is to get to the end of the race, keep everything in good condition, and try to stay out of trouble while you're at it.
First race of the season, then you're on pole. Let's bring home a win today.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. It's Williams in pole position then, edging out Raikkonen, who'll start P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Rosberg, Sebastian Vettel, and Ricciardo, Verstappen, Massa, Kvyat, and Fernando Alonso, Button, Grosjean, Carlos Sainz, and Hülkenberg, Gutierrez, Perez, Kevin Magnussen, and Marcus Ericsson, Palmer, and Wehrlein. Felipe Nasser and Rio Haryanto completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. win then for the Williams team today? Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And I can see our drivers making their way out now. It's been a sublime team performance, and it's the culmination of a lot of hard work. Williams are your winners today. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. We see a new name at the top of the championship table as we reach the end of the Grand Prix weekend. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Difficult call, Crofty, but I'd like to say Sergio Perez. He's just so gifted at getting the most out of his tyres, and he showed that here today.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Williams move to the top of the table. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye. And see you again next time.